Changes to its float inspections after one collapsed over the weekend during the school's homecoming parade.
10 students were hurt. Thankfully, none of those injuries life-threatening. Fox 31 problem solver Laura Wilson spoke exclusively with school officials today about just what those changes will look like moving forward. Joining us now from the newsroom on a story you'll see only on Fox 31. Laura.
The problem solvers have learned that float did pass inspection before the parade, and it's really more of a visual inspection. No specific numbers in terms of measurements or the number of students allowed on the trailer. School officials say that's about to change.
2 days after this scary sight.
Hearing about the injuries, it got to me for sure.
Things are starting to settle down on the School of Mines campus.
People are definitely shaken up after it, but I think everyone's kind of getting back to normal now.
10 students from Kappa Sigma and Sigma Kappa were injured Saturday after the trailer's hitch hit something, causing the float to tip over.
With as many people as they had, I think we're lucky that people didn't get more hurt or more people didn't get hurt.
School officials agree.
Our number one concern is the safety of our students.
Which is why the homecoming parade will be noticeably different next year.
As we look at those guidelines, I can guarantee you there will not be two-story structures any longer.
Currently, all floats must pass an inspection by the homecoming committee before entering the parade.
We look at it structurally, visually, but we need to do better there.
Which, according to Student Life VP Dan Fox, will mean better guidelines, especially when it comes to the size of the float and the number of students allowed on it.
I don't believe they're pulling out a tape measure and measuring that. The length of whatever float that will be built moving forward, the height, all those things will be definitely part of the process.
In the coming months, he says the school will look at regulations across the country to help mold their own. Their top priority right now, though, is making sure everyone affected by the accident makes a full recovery.
And as of our latest update, one of the students remains in the hospital after undergoing surgery. We're told everyone else has been released. In the newsroom, Laura Wilson, Fox 31.